Hallo und herzlich willkommen zu einem neuen Video der Reihe Pferderassen von A bis Z. Ich bin Lara vom Kanal Dandy Learns und heute sind wir auch schon beim Buchstaben J und somit bei der Pferderasse Jütländer angekommen. Und ich sage euch was, es war so schwer, diese Rasse im Generellen zu finden. Deswegen bin ich umso glücklicher, dass ich den Zuchtverband der Jütland Horse gefunden habe und jetzt hier auch schon live auf einer Hengstschau bzw. einer Hengstleistungsprüfung direkt in Dänemark stehe und ihr auch zahlreiche Hengste vertreten sind. Die liebe Anna wird mit uns heute dieses Video machen. Das heißt, es wird auch auf Englisch sein. Schaltet deshalb gerne einfach die Untertitel an. Da habe ich euch das Video dann auch ganz einfach auf Deutsch übersetzt. Hi Anna.
Hello.
How many stallions are getting approved, hopefully, today? And what is the stallion approval in the first place?
Yeah, we have 8 stallions here today, which is a pretty normal number, mm-hmm. between 8 to 10.
Yeah.
Last year we had 20, was a little special. So our stallion approval, selection, presentation, what you prefer to call it, is where we have our stallions. They have to be at least 3 years old, mm-hmm. and they come here to be approved for the breeding season coming up.
And what is your role in the Jutland Horse Society?
My family breeds Jutland horses.
Yeah.
We have done that for around 20-25 years.
Wow, okay.
So we have been a part of this society for a long time. I'm in the border here for the Jutland horses. Mm-hmm. So in general, we help with the show, and we don't have horses here today. I don't have a stallion here.
Yeah.
So we just help and make everything work. Mm-hmm. Yeah, stuff like that.
Okay, so you have a Jutland horse yourself?
Yeah.
One, or how many horses do you have?
We have 8 horses at home, and expect to have 2 to 3 foals this year.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. And can you tell us about the historical background of the Jutland horse?
It is our national draft horse, mm-hmm. this one here. The first stud book was in 1881.
Yeah.
There was a horse dealer in England who brought a stallion here named Oppenheimer. And from that stallion, we had our most famous stallion, Adolf Munkedal.
Yeah.
So we see him as the father of mm-hmm. the Jutland horses. So almost all Jutland horses came from there.
Okay, wow.
Yeah. So back in the years, they were used mostly in the fields for farmers' work.
Yeah.
But when the tractors come and stuff like that, the numbers dropped a lot.
Yeah.
So today, I think we are under 1,000 Jutland horses.
Okay.
In the streets of Copenhagen, it's normal to see them.
Yeah.
You probably know the beer Carlsberg.
Yeah.
They used a lot of Jutland horses mm-hmm. for driving around in the cities and delivering beer to pubs and stuff like
that.
It's still going on. They have around, I think, 4 horses today just for show.
Okay.
But they're not really used anymore because all the mechanics came and helped the farmers instead of the horses.
Yeah. What is the usage now for the Jutland horses if you say they're not used in work today?
It's more like a family horse today.
Okay.
So you can use it for almost everything. Of course, not, I say, fancy sport, you know, it's not a dressage or jumping horse.
Yeah.
But it's a family horse, you can ride it, mm-hmm. you can drag a wagon, you can also use it for field work just for fun. Some of us still do it. For riding places like this today, they can use for people maybe who has handicaps or something like that also.
Yeah.
So I think it's a good friend, you can help him for everything.
Und jetzt kommen wir auch schon zu den wichtigsten Fakten über den Jütländer. Den Ursprung hat diese Rasse im Jahr 1881 in Dänemark, wobei die Rasse schon vorab gezüchtet wurde. Das ist lediglich der Anfang des Zuchtbuchs. Die Rasse geht bis auf die Wikinger zurück und die Pferde wurden vorwiegend als Zugpferde und Arbeitstiere in der Landwirtschaft eingesetzt. Jütländer haben ein Stockmaß zwischen 1,58 m und 1,64 m. Und die Fellfarben sind Fuchs oder Lichtfuchs, aber auch andere Farben sind zugelassen. When it comes to the Jutland horse, how would you describe this breed in general? What are the main characteristics?
Yeah, we have a middle-sized horse.
Mm-hmm.
It needs to be muscular, deep and wide. It needs to have a cool temper, mm-hmm. working hard. But the temper in general is very important.
Yeah.
Because you need to be able to trust it. And again, it was a working horse on the field. You need to be able to trust when you say stay, you stay and work and work. So that's the main character for them.
How do the Jutland horses live here in Denmark? Are there any particularities when it comes to feeding them or taking care of them?
They are in general very easy. Mm-hmm. They prefer to be outside most of the time. So it's a little different. Some people have a barn where they can move in and out themselves.
Yeah.
Some people take them in winter and move them in and out. But okay. In general, many hours as feel as possible. They prefer to stay together, but mm-hmm. can easily be with other breeds also. That's mm-hmm. no problem. We feed them mostly with hay. It's very important because, again, they need yeah. some food. But otherwise, in general, just corn and vitamins. There's no special way for
okay.
them at all.
Yeah. Had you had a chance to observe some differences compared to other horse breeds?
I think it's hard to say because there's a lot of different breeds. But when we highlight the temper
yeah.
and their work willingness.
Mm-hmm.
So you have a trustful horse, again you have a family horse. You can use it for children to ride or something like that. We also have some people who use them in the forest, helping mm-hmm. move trees and stuff like that, where they don't want machines to ruin them.
Yeah.
You can use them for wagons and stuff like that. So in general, they're a very all-around horse.
Mm-hmm. And these stallions, are they also used for the work in the forest, or are they only breeding horses?
It's very different. Some of them will probably only be breeding horses,
yeah.
some will be riding horses, some will drive a wagon, and
okay.
different kind of work situation.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And let's imagine someone seeing this video right now
yeah.
and falling in love with this breed.
Yeah.
Would you have any tips for someone that wants to own a Jutland horse in the future?
Yeah, of course you need, like in practical, to have a room for them.
Yeah.
They require some kind of room on the field, they require some kind of food for them.
Yeah.
But otherwise, no. If you want a really kindful horse, more like a friend than a horse, actually.
Yeah.
If you want someone that the whole family can use, not a horse that you have to use every day, you can do it when you have time, because
yeah.
you can put him in the field and take him back a month later, and he'll still be very kind. You can take him to the forest. So, a very friendly horse.
Wusstest du, dass der Jütländer Nationalpferd Dänemarks ist? Unter anderem ist er auch Rekordhalter im Zugkraftwettbewerb. Bedeutet, er hat sogar einen eigenen Guinness-Buch der Rekorde-Eintrag. Die genetische Verbindung zu anderen schweren Kaltblutrassen ist übrigens auch gegeben. Und diese Pferde wurden vor allem als Brauereipferde und Kriegspferde eingesetzt. Sie haben zum Beispiel ganz, ganz schwere Kanonen gezogen. We are now at the heart of it all, where the Jutland horses are giving their best in front of the judges. Yes, me too. But what are the tasks the Jutland horses have to perform in, and how do they get approved to be stallions for breeding?
The first thing we do, we have the vet check.
Yeah.
For checking that the balls and everything is it's okay.
Yeah.
We take a blood test also for the DNA.
Mm-hmm.
And we measure their heights and weights and stuff like that. Then they are shown in front of the judges on the hard ground first, mm-hmm. in trot and walk, and afterwards in the indoor arena, also trot and walk, and yes. free also. That's the general test they have to do to get the points that we needed for the approval.
Okay.
If they would like, we have this obedience test afterwards, where it's more like how well behaved they are in different things. It could be like riding or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's like an extra thing we can do just to show that they also use for something.
Okay. And how many breeders are in your breeding program?
I actually don't know the exact numbers,
yeah.
but we are around 15 active members
yeah.
in the society. So around that, someone
okay.
only breeds like, you know, one foal a year,
yeah.
and someone breeds 8 to 10 foals a year.
Okay.
So, but we're not that many.
Mm-hmm.
No.
And is there something you want to tell the people about the Jutland horse, about the horses in Denmark?
In general, this horse is a wear horse.
Yeah.
We risk that this breed will extend
yeah.
if we are not really aware of it.
Mm-hmm.
We try to do different things to try to get new members
yeah.
and try to mix the blood so there will not be too many with the same stallion, because
mm-hmm.
that will also end up extending us.
Yeah.
So so in general, we really trying and hopefully we can keep this up. It's a part of the Danish history
yeah.
when we have this horse, so it means a lot to everybody, but yeah, there are not many horses left.
So if you want to maybe join the breeding program, you are the right person to talk to.
Absolutely.
Perfect. Hast du noch weitere Fragen zu dieser Pferderasse, dann stelle sie mir jetzt gerne in den Kommentaren oder schreibe mir ganz einfach direkt auf Instagram unter Dandy Learns. Im nächsten Video der Reihe Pferderassen von A bis Z stelle ich dir die Pferderasse mit dem Buchstaben K vor. Da kannst du gerne auch wieder raten, welche Pferderasse das sein wird. Auf jeden Fall ist es aber eine sehr geschichtsträchtige Pferderasse und dafür geht es auch zur Pferd-Bodensee-Messe in Friedrichshafen. Abonniert uns gerne, um nichts zu verpassen. Danke fürs Zuschauen und bis zum nächsten Mal.